You voted once, but some of your neighbors are accused of abusing the democratic process.
Today, the Hamilton County Board of Elections asked 9 people accused of voting twice or more in last November's presidential election for their side of the story. The most notable case involves veteran poll worker Meloise Richardson, who admitted voting absentee and in person, but says she didn't intend to commit voter fraud.
I can't understand these charges against me for voter fraud. Have they never heard of simple mistake? Have they never heard of overlooking mailing in a ballot or registering to vote at a precinct after you've forgotten that you've mailed in the ballot or you've been told that the ballot may be too late?
The Hamilton County prosecutor will decide if criminal charges should be brought against 6 people accused of voter fraud, including Meloise Richardson. 9 on Your Side reporter Tom McKee broke this story live downtown now with what's next in the process. Tom?
Well, certainly the prosecutor's office is going to be reviewing all the evidence in the case to see if criminal charges are warranted and should be presented to the grand jury. Now, of course, on the advice of her attorney, Meloise Richardson did not testify today, but she disputes these charges listed in this report and told me today in person that I disrespected her when I did an interview with her earlier this month. Board members here, though, don't agree with that line of thinking.
There's absolutely no intent on my part to commit any voter fraud.
That's what Meloise Richardson told me on February 6th, but added these words.
Yes, I voted twice.
Richardson said she mailed in an absentee ballot, but feared it would arrive too late to be counted.
I, after registering thousands of people, certainly wanted my vote to count, so I voted. I voted at the poll.
On Friday, Richardson showed up at the Board of Elections with an attorney. While her legal team discussed matters with prosecutors, she headed in my direction and said,
"You totally disrespected me the first time you filmed me. I wish you wouldn't do it again."
The board was told not to take any further action on the Richardson case or the case of Rosemarie Hewitt, a sister of Charity whose housemate, another nun, allegedly cast her ballot after Hewitt died. The prosecutor is already considering both of them. Other cases referred included Margaret Allen, Betty Ann Glossop, Ernestine Strickland, and Andre Wilson. After the hearing, board members said Richardson undermined voter confidence in the election process.
She took advantage of her position as an inside poll worker to allow herself to get 2 votes counted, and she's one of the only people, she is the only person that we are aware of in this election who had 2 votes counted. And then on top of that, it appears that she voted for a number of other voters as well, perhaps as many as 5 or 6.
Alex, in your opinion, did Meloise undermine the confidence in the voter system?
Yes. And I'll elaborate and tell you that the fact that she was a poll worker here is a concern as well. And I think we all believe that. It's very disconcerting.
Now, the board is also asking prosecutors for a review to see if there's a possible conflict in state law. On one hand, it's a felony to vote twice, but on the other hand, the law allows some people in certain circumstances to vote absentee and then cast a provisional ballot if only one vote is going to count. We'll keep you posted on what they say. Tom McKee, 9 on Your Side, live downtown.
All right, Tom, thanks for that report.